I'll make a motion to go back into open session. Do I hear a second? We have a motion and a second to go back into open session. Are there any questions or discussion on the motion? Hearing none, Ms. Williams, you may call the roll.
Mr. Beistel? Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell?
Yes.
Ms. Walton?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, Ms. Baker.
Yes, Ms. Baker here today for George R. Miller Medical Trust. This is about the second tract, smaller tract, right here. Earlier on the first zoning, Mr. Wakefield asked about whether it forms residential. And I said, oh, yes, it does. It does not. It adjoins residential down here, where it's already zoned industrial. So the part that we're looking to rezone, this right here, does not adjoin residential. I just want to point that out first. The residential that I saw on the map is down here. We're not looking to rezone that, it's already zoned industrial. So again, we're looking to rezone today, does not adjoin residential. Now, this one is 55 acres. 20 acres of that is already zoned industrial, 35 of it has. Judge, if I could, everything I said on the previous docket applies to this docket. I would just like to know to come up and adopt the things I previously made as a testimony to this docket, and we don't have much more to say.
That would be great, Ms. Baker. Thank you.
Mr. Miller, do you adopt the statements that I made on the previous docket as your testimony on this docket 28?
I do.
Yeah.
If you would, for clarification, you have two applications. Mr. Miller, as far as this application, this is far, I think, it's a local trust. And are you the trustee who is in R to speak on behalf of that trust?
Yes, sir.
And then you're adopted as trustee of the applicant, correct?
Correct, sir.
Thank you.
And I want to ask my usual question. Is there anyone here that wants to speak in favor of this zoning request?
You just have to speak. We don't have anything for the
Right. Thank you, Ms. Baker. Now I'm going to open it up to if there are people here that want to speak in opposition of this particular zoning request, which is 2015Z-28. If you would, if there's something new that you want to bring out about this particular zoning request, then you're welcome to speak. So, raise your hand. Yes, yes, ma'am.
We come up to the podium.
We have a sworn in again. Welcome.
I'm Sil Beckner, and I'm with 580 Cool Springs. And the only thing I want to say that could be clear for before was I want all masters and Judge Roberts to understand what was said before goes right, makes the statement right, goes for the second property. They're all in the same area. It's all going to be affected the same. So just keep that in mind that we're all going to be affected which way ever you vote. And I think our people here, our citizens, our voters, that put forth a good reason as to why you should not allow the zoning change. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
The weight limit. I have questions to that. How
property going to enforce weight limits on a public road. Secondly, there has been some confusion on the sewers. Yes, we all agree that apparently there is sewers, but these are commercial sewers. Are they going to be of any benefit? But I think the biggest thing here is that how does a landlord who's going to sell this property, how is he going, he can say you can't bring a semi-truck onto his property, but how is he going to enforce that unless first the infrastructure is there? I would like to hear how he's going to enforce that. Thank you.
Ms. Baker, would you mind, and Mr. Miller, trying to answer Ms. Abington's question?
Sure. We agreed to the deed restrictions that the users from this property would abide by the weight restrictions on Chapin's Lane. And if there's evidence that that's being violated, then there's recourse in the court system. And of course, he's not going to be out there on the side of the road making sure the road, the trucks are weighed and all that. He can't do that. But there will be recourse through the court system if it's found that those are being violated. It would be a deed restriction that would run with the property even beyond its ownership. So it would limit the current future owners.
Thank you, Ms. Baker. Any questions from Ms. Baker's issues? Okay. And now, on this section, who else would like to speak? Yes, sir, Mr.
Frank.
Yeah, go ahead. Frank. Frank.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, this is for number 28.
First, I'd like to say that in the first meeting, I was only here for number 27, and I left about quarter after 10, when the Planning Commission talked about putting 28 on hold until the following meeting, because it was running so late. I left, and then after I left, I found out the next day that they actually did hold the meeting on C-28 after 10 o'clock. Everything that was discussed about the ferns, the trees, all those things were discussed while I was here when we were talking about Z-27. So the berms and the residential areas, all that was discussed at that time. And I'd like to point out the road that Mr. Miller is willing to straighten out is not in 28. This is 28 over here. This is 27. This is the curve that goes through Chapin's that he's talking about straightening out. There's an old farmhouse here. And he was talking about taking a road from here and going straight across. He has to cross 27 to get to 28. So the fact that he's talking about the road being straightened in 28 doesn't make sense, because here's the curve, and this is in 27. And like I said, I left before they started discussing 28, because they had said that they were going to postpone it for the next meeting because it was already so late. So everything that was said about putting the trees in through here where the houses are, because my house is basically right there. This is where I live. This is what everyone out here. I've got 6 acres. And it's up right up to it, about that right here. And these are the neighbors that I have. And this is where we talked about ferns, all the trees, and everything that we've done. I'm going to say there. Not over here. Like I said, I wasn't here for this one at all, so I left. So there seems to be a mix-up between the 27 and the 28. So they're talking about the 28, and I'm going to separate the neighbors. There are no neighbors here. It's all over here. There is no curve on Chapin's at 28. It's all in 27, and that's really all I have.
And Mr. Baker, let's let Ms. Baker speak on that issue, okay?
Mr. Miller, or Miller Enterprises, owns that property that's under 27. He was just agreeable that since he owns that property, he'll do that whether that one was approved or not. So that's a restriction on 28, but since he's still agreeable, even though 27 was not approved by the Planning Commission, he's still agreeable to donate whether the land is necessary to stretch.
Okay.
And the same restrictions were just discussed on both applications. That's why the restrictions really would have had applied more to 27. He was agreeable to the same restrictions being put in place.
Any questions from the magistrates? And Mr. Kramer
to the same restrictions on both properties. But that's what was said, it was gonna be done on 27, and then he had made reference to, he would apply the same restrictions to 28. The straightening of the road is done on 27, not 28. Because there is no.
And just, Mr. Miller, he can agree to form about the widening to donate along all of the property, so he can probably have had a discussion, he owns quite a bit of the long streets. He's gonna donate along all of his property, for the price of the street.
Thank you, thank you very much.
And who else, and this, yes, ma'am. Parker, Holly Parker.
Yes.
I actually just have a question for you. Have any of you been out there to see the property and like how it's going to affect us? Like where its location is as opposed to where we are in the neighborhood? That's all, I just wanted to know if you guys have.
Thank you, Parker, and yes.
That's all right.
I just wanna point out here that we have sworn testimony by one of my neighbors here that said that the planning and zoning committee admitted to him after the meeting the reason that one was approved and one was disapproved. And if that's the kind of way that things are done here, and I think it's up to the fiscal court to correct the mistake that the planning and zoning commission made, because their very own paperwork in the rebuttal denial says why it should not be approved. Everything was there, and while we were having all this discussion, it should have been both denied to begin with, and then none of us would all be here missing our lunch.
So we had a Bennett Field.
when we got on the second track, or the 35 acres, well, we go back, when we were going on the first one, you know, I was down on my fingers, and I'm like, oh, man, you know, someone was like, no, they voted, we really wanted it, so, okay, great. And then when we were voting on the second one, they changed their vote the opposite way that they were voting up here. So it had me all screwed up, and I'm thinking, those could be been this one, and somebody said, no, you lost this one, you know, you wanted to pass it. So there was some confusion going around on the voting area. And I don't know if that's the way y'all are never voting. But then it was strictly hearsay that I had heard. And talking about being loud, we weren't really loud that day. I mean, we were little, you know, 10 o'clock, Lord have mercy. It's getting late. And, but as far as being disrespectful, I don't think we were that. But I had heard one of the fellas said that there was so much going on that he even voted the wrong way. That's a picture. But seriously, that's all I had.
Thank you, Debbie.
If y'all want to ask me anything.
We're going to close this. Yeah, it was time to close. Thank you all very much. This is the end of the public hearing and first reading for 2015Z-28. And I want to thank everyone in this room for being respectful to each other. Both sides have been extremely respectful. I appreciate everyone knowing how important it is to hear each side of the story. So I want to thank everyone here. And with that said, we're going to move on with our agenda, unless there's something else I'm missing. Before you leave, the vote will take place January the 5th, right here in this room. Be sure and contact the five people you see up here, the four magistrates and myself. A lot of you all have already contacted me. I've responded back to you.
Will you announce the time, January 5th?
9:30.
Thank you.
9:30 right here. So if you wish to leave, go right ahead. We're going to move on with the Moore County business. And thank you all very much.
Thank you. We've got it tough.
Okay, let's move on. We are on, now we're going to go back to our agenda under new business. Gary Moore, 2015 Republican presidential office.
It should be 2016.
Oh, yeah, it should be. Sorry, Gary.
Well, probably everybody here knows we started on the news myself. But I'm here to make everybody and hopefully you all spread the word about the upcoming 2016 Kentucky Republican presidential caucus, which will be March 5th, 2016, which is the first Saturday in March. The Bullitt County voting location will be Little Central High School. The voting hours from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And you must be a registered Republican in order to vote in this caucus. And I want to thank y'all for the opportunity to speak. As of last week, we had 7 candidates that have filed. They had until January the 7th to file. We have Bush, Trump, Cruz, Carson, Rubio, Paul, and one gentleman's name I always mess up, K-A-I-S-C-H. Casey. Yes, we have filed. And we have until December the 31st to register to vote. In this caucus, you have to be a registered Republican to vote. So if you're not registered for one party or the other, you have until December 31st to register a Republican. Or if you want to change from Democrat to Republican, you can. So I'm asking for any registered Republicans to volunteer to work at this caucus. Ours aren't as long as the regular primary or general election, and it'll be a little bit more laid back. Some things are a little different on absentee ballots that you can obtain, and the voting, the ballots will be indeed counted at the location, so we will know what our count is that afternoon. We won't be able to possibly leave it public, but the votes will be tabulated there before they're sent to a central location. The ballots will be kept, and there's a recount. They'll have the ballots there. So if anybody wants to volunteer, please see me. I have some flyers if anybody would be interested in those. And if you have any questions, I'll be glad to try to answer them. I don't have any answers, I'll try to get them for you. So,
I might want to say to everything, you're looking for volunteers, everything looked up before you, 17-year-old, the rest of the Republican, they can come out, volunteer, as long as they'll be 18, but they don't want to. You look pretty good.
So, like I said, I've got some cards, write your names down, or do you think of anybody that might be interested in volunteering or not here? Please fill out a card and give you your name and what way to contact, and I'd be glad to do so. So, if there are any more questions, I thank you all for your time.
Thank you, Gary.
And Gary, thank you for taking it upon yourself to do this office, because it's very important. Right. Like you said, we want all parents to be participating. And
they're predicting about a 30% turnout, and I hope we can do better than that. So that's the reason I'm trying to get the word out.
All right, thanks, Gary.
What was the date again?
The date is March the 5th, which is a Saturday, first Saturday of March. Yeah. And I want to make sure that people know that the Republican candidates for president will not appear on the primary. So look, don't come in May on one of those, because they won't be just the Democrats and the other people that have the problems. Thank you.
This is beautiful.
Number four, action requested to change payroll date to December 23rd and distribute payroll checks on that date due to the Christmas holiday.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion on the motion? Ms. Williams, may call the roll.
Yes.
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes.
Mr. Boswell?
Yes.
Thank you, Ms. Williams. And number five, is Marvel supposed to present this, does anybody know? The sheriff's office, 2015 budget amendments?
Representing that department, is that?
Yeah, this is. Yes.
Apparently they decided to leave.
Yes, it was the budget.
Budget, right.
But this was supposed to be presented.
That's why I didn't find this grant, is here.
What do you want?
Stay with, what is the move?
Well, yeah, I mean, that has to be done. But, we can have a special meeting. We're willing.
Because that's not changing, we need to vote on it, she just presents it, right?
No, we have to vote on it, because it says action requested. This is an amendment, not the budget.
Right. This works really money from law.
Yeah.
Right, so do we have to, inside our budget, what do we do?
We have to take action on it, we have, that's why it's an action requested. But it's not the budget, it's the amendment.
Well, this is presented, you know. It's highlighted here a little, what's being, there's no money being added to it. There's no money around in their budget. I make a motion to approve the budget amendment to the sheriff's department, moving money. No money's added to it, it's third, moving no money around.
It's just the amendment. Okay, we have a motion, what are your second? Thank you all. We have a motion and a second to the 2015 budget amendments. Yes. Any questions or discussion on that? And Ms. Lynch, you can call the roll.
Judge Roberts.
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell.
Yes.
Mr. Lawson.
Yes.
Mr. Lasso.
Yes.
Mr. Reagan.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah, hey, Marvel. Ms. Marvel, y'all, come on in, since you're in here. We just now approved the budget amendments.
Okay.
Because this was on the agenda.
We took a look at that out. I just need to know that name.
Very nice out.
Yeah.
Okay, so Marvel, that we just wanted to let you know that we passed it, it's on the agenda. And this is the budget amendment.
Right.
Okay. Thank you for coming in, we're finished with that now.
Okay.
Okay, for number six, magistrates, I would like to table number six until January the 2nd. Is it over? Keith, is it over?
No, I didn't go in. I don't even know where it is.
Oh, the deputy judge said you were going in for the press conference.
I was. I don't know where it is.
For what is?
The press conference. Is it in his office?
It's in the break room. Okay, number six, Bullock County Government Motor Vehicle Policy. I'll make a motion to table it if I can get a second. And I'll open it on the January 2nd agenda. Some folks, I'm sorry, January 5th. But if y'all want to second the motion, that's fine. But some folks need to be communicated to concerning this motor vehicle policy. Okay, the motion dies for lack of second. So y'all want something to take care of then? That were not communicated. needed to. Not that they had to have a say-so in it, which would have been helpful, but at least some communication should have occurred before the passage of this. And that's my statement. Any other questions or discussion on the recall policy? We have none this week, Ms. Allen.
Ms. Mitchell.
Yes.
Mr. Lawson.
Yes.
Mr. Blackwell.
Yes.
Mr. Rayo.
Yes.
Ms. Roberts.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Number seven, and that's all, I want to thank you for being willing to do this.
Yes, it's something we need to do.
We do.
This is quite similar, I think, what we're gonna have, and we're gonna explore every way we can to pick up sponsors and whatever, see if we can place this with them. We'll give it a try, because we've got right now with these pools, and like, it's like broken down problem, just keep putting money in, next year we got more money, so we're just looking at this, the benefit of the whole county.
So I'll make a motion to appoint Magistrate Dennis Mitchell to the Bourne County Aquatic Center Committee and to be my service chairman.
Yes.
And the service chairman, thank you, yes. Do I hear a second to my motion? We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion on the motion? Let's do, we want this to be more down. Let's wait till the next meeting. We'll try to have an answer for you. At the next meeting, should be January 5th. Okay, any other questions or discussion on the motion? Hearing none, Ms. Lee, you may call the roll.
Mr. Lawson.
Yes.
Mr. Blackwell.
Yes.
Mr. Rayo.
Yes.
Ms. Roberts.
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell.
Yes.
Okay, number eight. I think he meant to go somewhere. I make a motion to appoint Keith Rippey to the Bullock County Aquatic Center Committee and to serve as vice chairman. Do I hear a second to my motion?
Yes.
Thank you, guys. We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Ms. Lee, we'll get if you want the dates on there. Okay. And Ms. Lee, you may call the roll.
Mr. Blackwell.
Yes.
Mr. Rayo.
Yes.
Ms. Roberts.
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell.
Yes.
Mr. Lawson.
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell.
Yes. Okay. I don't think there's anything next, is there?
Make a motion to go into the session.
Okay.
For litigation purposes.
And what do you want?
I'd like to have county attorney, if I can get Keith Griffin, deputy judge. Okay.
Deputy judge and county attorney and Ron Malone.
Sure.
John is okay?
Sure. No, very well.
Is that what he has?
That's all.
All right. And then, okay. I'll second that motion. Any questions or discussion on that motion? Ms. Lee, you may call the roll.
Mr. Rayo?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Mr. Mitchell?
Yes.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Blackwell?
Yes.